Hello everyone, this is Jan Chromý and together we will continue the course Interdisciplinary Approaches to Language and its Use. In this presentation, we will focus on the bilingual lexicon. We already discussed this topic from the perspective of bilingual language acquisition, and we presented some findings considering the vocabulary size in monolinguals and bilinguals, and we also dealt with the role of exposure. Now, we will focus on how the lexicon of bilinguals is organized. The question is, how are the two or more lexicons interconnected in the bilingual brain? A classical approach to this question was a proposal by Uriel Weinreich. Weinreich distinguished three types of bilingualism based on a relation between the conceptual and form representations. The first type is coordinate bilingualism. According to Weinreich, coordinate bilinguals have separated conceptual representations for each language. For example, a Czech-German coordinate bilingual would differentiate between the concept dveře, which is a form dveře in Czech, and the concept dítě, which is a form dítě in German. The second type is compound bilingualism. Compound bilinguals have an identical conceptual representation for the words in their languages, and for this representation there are separate forms. For example, a Czech-German compound bilingual would distinguish between the forms dveře and dítě, but both these words would stand for the identical concept. The last type is subordinate bilingualism, which is typical for bilinguals with a high dominance of one language according to Weinreich. Subordinate bilinguals have one concept which has a specific form representation in the first language, and the form representation of the word in the second language is then related to the form representation in the first language. In other words, when retrieving the word in the second language, subordinate bilinguals need to retrieve it first in their first language. Weinreich's view was very influential for a long time. However, from the current point of view, it is rather obsolete. Already in the 1990s, Anne de Groot argued that the words of a bilingual speaker differ in respect to the relation between the conceptual representation and the form representation. In other words, de Groot suggested that it is untenable to classify bilingual speakers as compound, coordinate, or subordinate because all three representational structures may be found within the lexicon of an individual bilingual. This means that a Czech-German bilingual may store some words in a compound fashion, other in coordinate fashion, and even other in a subordinate fashion. Importantly, de Groot claims that there are certain tendencies in the way how the bilinguals store the information. For example, she claims that concrete words and cognates are stored typically as compound, whereas abstract words and non-cognates typically as coordinates. More recent views of the bilingual lexicon assume that it is even more complicated. This is a schema of a shared distributed asymmetrical model by Yangping Dong, Shichun Gui, and Brian McGuinney. The authors argue that there is a shared storage for the conceptual representations of the bilingual's two vocabularies, and there are asymmetrical links between concepts and forms in the two languages. This model can thus cover bilinguals with a very different language dominance because it predicts that the dominant L1 language would have stronger links to the common elements than the weaker second language. Importantly, the model also suggests that bilinguals also maintain specific conceptual elements for both languages. Before we will conclude this presentation, I have one reading tip for you. If you want to learn more about the bilingual lexicon, you should read a recent review article, Words on the Brain, the Bilingual Mental Lexicon, by Susan Bob and Judith Kroll, which was published in the book Bilingual Cognition and Language. Bob and Kroll discussed the cross-language activation of the two languages of a bilingual and its consequences. If you enjoyed the presentations, we would be glad if you would like them on YouTube. That is all from me now. See you next time.